Are you currently suffering from a headache that's over the top or back side of your head? This is a common presentation of a cervicogenic headache, where your neck is actually causing your headache. My name is Dr. Zach Greenwood, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to identify this headache versus other headaches, what's actually causing your headache in your neck, and then some amazing exercises to help resolve it on your own. Structures that are important with this condition are the top three vertebrae or bones of your neck. So C1, C2, and C3. And this is the bone called the occiput, which is the base of your skull. And these bones and joints and muscles are what's causing your pain, and we'll describe that in further detail in a second. Headaches are the third leading cause of disability worldwide, affecting about 4.1% of the population. And they greatly impact both quality of life and then social participation. This kind of headache affects both the top or back of your head, and there's usually a very gradual onset. And with this kind of headache compared to other headaches, there's no nausea, light sensitivity, or sound sensitivity. And often flexing or bringing your chin down will increase your headache. Whereas a migraine is normally more in the front, it's very sudden, there's a pulsating effect, and often there's nausea, light sensitivity, or sound sensitivity. And then a tension headache is bilateral. You'll often feel like a tightening or kind of a constricting feeling, and this is often improved with exercise. We're gonna cover these in more detail later in the video, but it's important to kind of distinguish which headache you're dealing with for the most effective treatments. And when talking with headaches, we do have to cover some red flags. So if you have paralysis, double vision, or slurred speech, that's an immediate medical referral and you should go straight to the emergency room. So how the heck can your neck cause your headache? We'll explain that right now. So again, going back to that model, the top of your neck, so C1, C2, and C3, and the base of your skull, your occiput, so right here. Well, these structures interact with another structure in your brainstem called the trigeminal cervical nucleus. Think of my right hand as those joints of your upper neck, and my left hand is that brain structure. There's this overlap or kind of insertion between the two. So when your joints get mad, they irritate that part of your brainstem, which refers pain up towards your head. So by treating these muscles and joints and nerves, you can help facilitate your headache to go away. And that's why your neck pain can cause your headache. There's a lot of different triggers that can affect your headache, with the top five being neck pain, tiredness, temperamine, restless sleep, and odors. For the exercise and stretches that are most effective, we want to focus on this top part of the neck. So when you're doing this, really think about working this part and not the lower neck. For these, you need a small ball. This is a massage ball we got on Amazon, but a tennis ball or something else will work. But again, it needs to be relatively soft and you don't want to push too hard. For the first exercise, lay on your back and place the ball just below your occiput or the base of your skull. Keep the ball in position with one hand and you're going to slowly tilt the chin up and down several times. This should be very gentle pressure at first. I can't emphasize that enough. The next one, put the ball at the same position and hold it with your hand. But this time we're gonna roll our head left and right slowly. Initially start with a small range of motion and over time try to increase it. But again, we're trying to focus on that upper neck, not the whole neck. This one you'll need to roll up a towel or a sweatshirt, laying on the ground, place it under your neck. Then you're gonna retract or tuck your chin while simultaneously pressing your neck and head down onto the floor with mild tension. Start with 5-second holds and then increase over time as your symptoms allow. For this exercise, we're gonna tuck or retract our chin backwards and then tilt our head to the side as far as we can and then return to the starting position. Repeat on the opposite side. Keep your chin tucked through the whole motion and really emphasize tension on the upper neck, not the lower neck. This exercise will require a lightweight resistance band or PT band. You're gonna anchor with the band on the chest with the opposite arm, wrap it behind your neck, and then cross the back of your neck with your other arm just below your hairline or that base of the skull. Now keeping some mild tension, you're gonna pull and rotate your head simultaneously to help self-mobilize that upper neck. Now again, this is involving the neck and a cord, so be careful and do mild tension and only rotate as far as comfortable. With this headache, some posture modifications can be huge. So again, this condition does not like when you flex your neck. So working prolonged periods on your laptop, on the couch is not helpful. Sitting in bed where you're propped up on your pillows and your chin is kind of tucked down can also be painful. One thing to be aware is if your pillow is very thick when you sleep, that can also flex the neck and cause your symptoms to be worse. And then the last thing you want to think about is if you have two monitors and you spend a lot of time looking to one side, it may be beneficial to kind of straighten that out and just put one right in front of you and see if that helps reduce your symptoms. With headaches, there's lots of different theories and people kind of give you different reasons of what's causing your headache. But here's a cluster of three findings that have evidence behind them to show that your accurate diagnosis for the cervicogenic headache. Number one, pain sensitivity of palpation of the upper cervical spine or neck. Number two, impairment of movement. There's a loss of range of motion, especially the upper cervical spine. And number three, there's poor muscle control. Cervicogenic headache. It's on the top or back of your head. It's generally people over the age of 30 years old. There's a gradual onset. Flexing or bringing your chin down increases your headache, and there's no nausea, light sensitivity, or sound sensitivity. Tension headache. It's bilateral or both sides of your head. It lasts minutes to days. It's mild to moderate in intensity. There's a tightening feeling around your head, and it usually waxes or wanes. It improves with physical activity, and it may have light sensitivity or sound sensitivity, but not both. So migraine. This affects just one side of your head, often in the front of your head. It's more common in females than males. It typically lasts anywhere between 4 and 72 hours, and you can have one with or without aura. There's a pulsating feeling, and there's often accompanied with nausea, light sensitivity, and sound sensitivity. Anyone that's ever suffered from a headache has likely taken an over-the-counter drug like Tylenol or an NSAID. But there's a catch to this. If you take that medication more than 15 times in one calendar month, your headache is partially due to medication overuse. So by taking that medication, the more you take, you're actually making your headache more intense and more chronic. So figuring out a way to either take less of it over time or substituting to a different medication or trying to use heat or ice is very important in the long term. So you may actually have more headaches immediately after, but trying to figure out and work with someone to reduce your medication over time is paramount. We can't overstate how important sleep is with dealing with headaches. Remember those triggers? Two of the top five were tiredness and restless sleep. So working on improving the quality and quantity of sleep is extremely important. And here are some good tricks to try to help do that. Don't eat or drink 2 to 3 hours prior to going to bed. Go to bed at the same time each and every night. Make sure your room is very dark or wear a blindfold. No phone for a couple hours prior to going to bed. Some people may benefit from melatonin, and then general exercise throughout the day can help with quality of sleep. Thank you for watching our video on cervicogenic headaches. We hope you understand a better idea of the mechanism of what's causing your headache, and then have some awesome tools and exercises to help address it. If you did find this video helpful, please like our video, subscribe to our channel, and then we got lots of other great videos that you can check out.